Will you accept some samples of our work?
Thank you. so much data to digest. Never before have we had such an explosion of new media. Spawning, multiplying, frothing at the mouth. Each radiating along with data its tendrils towards each of us. These nodes with existing information flows to create a cacophony of data.
Cell phones, faxes, voicemail,
pages,
couriers,
email,
radio, catalogs, answering machines,
floppy disks, magazines, multi-section newspapers,
cable TV,
digital TV,
boring TV! Internet shopping, virtual travel, video on demand. Then there are memos, reports, executive overviews, briefings, press kits, strategic outlines, backgrounders, newsletters, braces, abstracts, facts, digests, summaries, statements, analyses. Have you had Paradox in there? Always remember a paradox. At the end of the 20th century, no matter how much information we get, somehow it always fails as if something is missing!
Okay, it was 100 years ago today that Claude Debussy taught the band to play. Now, we don't want this to sound too much like some kind of PBS educational film. So imagine that Claude, for the sake of argument, is played today by Brad Pitt or Bart Simpson. Keep that in your mind. This man called Claude is the hero of our story. And it's a story about ideas. Ideas, the most beautiful and threatening thing in the world. Where do they come from? Where do they go? What you can hear now is the sound of an idea in the embryo. This is the sound of something about to be born. And any minute now, for the sake of you, of the people who put the A into Chicago, out of noise, born again.
So where do ideas come from? Thank you for asking that question. It's a good first question. They come from in here. But how do they get in here? For Claude Debussy, the hero of our story, I guess they came in here because of water. He loved water. In fact, he was particularly fond of scuba diving, and he had a favourite resort in the south of France that he liked to go to. And he ordered his equipment from www.scuba.com. And when he got to the south of France, he would go under the surface of the water looking for these ideas. And he would go deeper and deeper, deeper into the dark, looking for these ideas that would be so important out there, deeper and deeper into the dark. And these ideas would come, and he would hold on to them for dear life, and then he would turn back towards the surface. And he would head higher and higher, up towards the surface, up higher and higher, holding on to these ideas that would only make sense if he could just break through that surface, higher and higher. And then he would head higher and higher, up, up towards the light, higher and higher, and then he would burst through the surface of the sea with these ideas out into the open air.
We had a great lunch today with the rock band Kiss. Both Kiss and Art of Noise have been invited, maybe that they're going to base some World Wrestling Federation characters on members of each of our bands, and we were just swapping some ideas there. And Kiss, I'll tell you something about Kiss, they gave us some great advice. They told us that whenever you play one of your greatest hits, that you should follow it up with a section devoted to the 19th century French poet, Charles Baudelaire. And we've spent all afternoon knocking it up with the help of Kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, Art of Noise, and the section devoted to the 19th century poet, Charles Baudelaire. Now comes the time when vibrating on its stem, each flower exhales like a censer. The violin throbs like an afflicted heart, a tender heart which hates the huge black void. The sky is as sad and beautiful as whatever you think it's as sad and beautiful as. It's a tragedy when the feeling's gone and you can't go on. It's just a tragedy. Now comes the time when vibrating on its stem, each flower exhales like a censer. The violin throbs like an afflicted heart, a tender heart which hates the huge black void. The huge black void.
The skies are sad and beautiful. As anything you want to imagine is sad and beautiful. Metaphor in pop. Why, for goodness sake, it's either us or Moby. Who else? Always be intoxicated. It is the key to all. The one question. In order not to feel the horrible burden of time breaking your back and bending you toward the earth, you must become drunk. Without truce. But on what? On wine, poetry, or virtue as you wish, but you must get drunk. On the steps of a palace, on the green grass of a ditch, in the mournful solitude of your room, you awaken. And your intoxication is already diminished, all gone. Ask the wind, the wave, the star, the bird, the clock. Everything that rolls, that speaks, that groans, that flees, that sings, that speaks. Ask what time it is. And the wind, the wave, the star, the bird, the clock will answer you. It is time to get intoxicated. In order not to be slaves martyred by time, always become intoxicated. On wine, on poetry, or on virtue, as you will. Thank you very much. We just get more and more human, don't we? Claude Debussy, who is, in fact, the hero of our story, he didn't believe in God. He didn't believe in the establishment. He didn't believe in bourgeois convention. He didn't believe in Beethoven or Wagner. Although he knew exactly the difference between Thelonious Monk and Liberace. Claude Debussy, the hero of our story, the father of, amongst others, Andy Warhol, Charlie Mingus, Brian Eno. He believed in the thing that all artists ultimately believe in. Claude Debussy, the hero of our story, a rock and roll hero. He believed in himself. Understood that a work of art or an effort to create beauty would always be looked upon by some people, as a personal attack. The hero of our story. He hated to appear in public. He hated to conduct. He hated to play piano at concerts. He hated to shake hands with Howard Hughes. He hated to swap wigs with Andy Warhol. He hated to hold money in his hand. Claude Debussy, he preferred robots to people.
Oh, yeah. volatile personality, activated by a savage insensitivity. The holy ego ism of genius.
I didn't.
Well, why not?
I have better things to do.
Can I say something?
No.
Well, I'm going to.
What?
Bum.
Bum.
Bum?
Bum.
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 We've done them all, I think. Hey. Oh, no, we haven't done hey. Hey!
The hay that launched the million ships.
Pocket, or are you just delighted to see us?
Thank you.
friend. Act your shoe size, honey, not your age. I want information. Give me information. I want information. I want to talk, I want to chat, I want to moan, I want to list, I want to rant, I want to want. I want to know, I want to hide. I want to hope, I want to shape, I want to contemplate. I want information.com. I want to guide, I want to need, I want to sell, I want to buy, I want to cheat. I want to form, I want to dream, I want to scheme. I want information. I want to know what's gonna be on the cover of Vanity Fair. I need information.
The piano. Imagine an actor saying the following. Imagine Jude Law as Arthur Rambo saying the following. When Claude Debussy died in March the 25th, 1918, in Paris, the city was being bombarded by a bunch of unfriendly aliens played by Kevin Spacey. And you know what they say, when it's raining and a city's being bombed, it must be very dark indeed. And guess what? Cue special effects. It was indeed very dark. To his lover, Arthur Rambo. This was 100 years ago. And in it, he said that it was raining in his heart, like it was raining in the town. And Debussy, he read this poem, and he put it to music, as if he'd already heard of Moby and Miles Davis.
Oh,
and it's raining in my heart. Like it's raining in the town. Thank you.
everybody put your eyes together and imagine that you're clapping your hands. Possibilities. It's what we've always been interested in. Thank you for joining us in this search for possibility. And last night I had a dream. I had a dream that I had a dream. And in this dream I dreamt that you've got to have a dream. Because if you don't have a dream, how are you going to make your dream come true? If you've got another 3 hours, we'll do it all again.
Thank you.